To write applications with Node.js, you'll need to have Node.js installed first. The best way to install Node.js for local development is by using a tool called NVM. In this tutorial, we'll walk through installing the NVM tool, which is just a shell script that we are going to run from the command line. Then, we'll use NVM to install the latest long-term support version of Node.js. And finally, we'll show you how to install and switch between different versions of Node.js. NVM is a bash script that helps us manage Node.js versions installed on your local machine. New versions of Node.js are released regularly, so it helps to have a tool to allow you to safely upgrade and switch between versions. NVM lets you have multiple versions of Node.js installed on your system while keeping each version separate. NVM also allows you to set a default version to use, so you always come back to the main version you're working with whenever you start a new terminal session. NVM is meant to be used for managing your node versions during development. That means that you should not use NVM in production environments. When in production, we suggest you rely on your operating system package manager or whatever server-side tooling is your choice to install and lock the environment to a specific version of Node.js. And finally, there's a Windows-specific version of NVM called NVM Windows. The main NVM project deals with Unix-based systems, so Mac and Linux. We're going to be working with the Unix-based NVM project. If you're on Windows, you should search for the NVM Windows project on the internet and make sure to follow those installation instructions instead. You can find the installation instructions for NVM in the NVM repository of the NVM SH GitHub organization. Find the installation section of the README and then copy the curl command to download the install script. If you paste this into your terminal, it'll download and then run the install script. I already have NVM installed, so my output is going to look a little bit different than yours. The script will update your profile in order to add NVM to your path. Before you can use NVM, you'll either need to exit and open a new terminal session or source the profile that you're using. For me, since I'm using ZSH, I would source my ZHSRC file, which in this case is called .screencast_ZHSRC. If none of that makes any sense to you, just go ahead and exit your terminal and open up a new terminal again. After you've restarted your terminal or sourced your profile, go ahead and type in command-v nvm in order to verify that the nvm command is now available to you. If it is, then it should just output nvm. Finally, you can just type in the nvm command and see all of the available options if you'd like. Now we're going to install the latest long-term support version of Node.js. We could do this by typing nvm install --lts. At the time of recording, the latest LTS version of Node is 12.14.0. But regardless of when you're actually watching this and installing it, using the --lts flag will install whatever the latest stable version is. If this is the first version of Node you've installed with NVM, it's also going to set this LTS version as your default alias. That means that whenever you start a new terminal session, it's going to automatically use this Node.js version, which we've just installed. The real benefit of NVM, though, is that it allows us to install multiple versions of Node.js. You might want to do that when you're working on a project which uses a specific version of Node.js, and you want to be able to test the project against that. Pass a version number when using NVM install in order to install a specific version of Node.js. You can install the latest available version of Node by running NVM install Node. You can use the NVM ls command to see which versions of Node you already have installed. And now that we have several different versions of Node installed, we can switch between them by using the NVM use command. You can always check to see which version of Node you're currently running by typing node-v. If you decide you want to use a different version of Node as your default, you can type nvm alias default and then the version number to have your system use that version every time you create a new terminal shell. One last thing you should know about is that each version of Node you install with nvm will have its own globally installed modules. So, for example, on Node version 12.14.0, I already have some globally installed modules. But if I switch to version 13, you'll see that I don't have any globally installed modules listed. the two different versions of Node aren't sharing my global modules at all. I can't actually share the global modules between the different versions, but when you install a new version, you can tell it to also install all of your global modules from any other version you have installed. When you're installing a new version of Node, or even after you've already installed it, you can pass the flag --- reinstall packages from, and then give it the version number that you want to install the packages from. This is really useful for when you're upgrading your Node version, but you also want to be able to bring along all your previously installed global packages that you use. To recap, we installed the NVM shell script from GitHub and onto our system. We used NVM to install the latest LTS version of Node.js, as well as several other different versions. And then we were able to use whichever Node version we wanted by switching between them, as well as setting a default which will be used whenever we start a new shell.